Hey, what's going on, team? It's Ricky with TechBit Solutions, and today we have a pretty interesting video. Just because the overall market nicely pulled back on Friday, and yes, I did say nicely, one of the really great things about this is if you didn't trade on Friday or the days leading up to it when the market was pulling back a little bit, this is a great time not to buy every stock out there, but because the overall market pulled back, a lot of these stocks pulled back as well. So this could be a great time to begin to build your watch list. And this is, I wanna say, just, you know, getting your feet wet in these stocks that I think that you should take into consideration, as this is just simply my opinion. I hope that throughout this video, with all the stocks that we talk about today, over 20 of them, even just one of them meets your criteria, you can add it to your watch list, you can set those alerts, and it gets you one step closer to your overall goal. I understand having nearly or over 20 of them, they're not all gonna meet your criteria, and that's a great thing. It's because we don't see eye to eye on everything, and you should always be empowered to be your own person. But I hope that at least one of them does. And if you guys like these videos, all I ask you to do is to drop a thumbs up and, of course, have an amazing MLK day. So let's go ahead and get started. I wanna talk about Apple. After 180-day highs at 138, it has pulled back to the SMA line. And Apple at the SMA line tends to bounce. Patterns tend to repeat themselves. They don't always have to. I just wanted to talk about it because usually these tech stocks are very overbought, very overextended, and it's nice to see them pulling back. Again, it doesn't mean that they have to bounce now, and things can get worse before they get better. So if you choose to buy early, please watch that position size, as you want to take into consideration the ability to be able to tolerate a pullback or tolerate some form of continuous descending pattern. If you don't want to be able to do that, or you don't want to have to tolerate that, then holding back, setting alerts, and following up with it when it actually begins to indicate signs of an overall reversal might be something more of value. From where we're at right now, right around the SMA line to previous 180-day highs, that's a 9.4% return, which I find to be pretty impressive and attractive when it comes down to Apple. The next one is Adobe, ticker symbol ADBE. As of right now, it's trading right around 460 a share, 458 to be exact, and based off of previous resistance levels, right around 500 to about 505, you guys can see that it offers nearly a 5% ROI. Based off of previous support levels, right around this 460 area, you can see that it's bounced here before after it consolidates and then indicates signs of an uptrend. This is, in a sense, what we're waiting out for, so all we have to do is set those alerts. Once we get proper indication of that overall reversal, right, we wait for the rejection, consolidation, and then confirmation, indication of an uptrend, then we can decide to buy a little bit when the overall direction is in our favor. Because like we say so many times before, it's already difficult to make money in the market. It is so much easier to make money in the market when the overall direction is in your favor. Think about it. The next one I want to talk about is AMD. This one right now is trading at $88 based off of previous 180-day highs at $99. And one of the things that you guys should know is that it does have up-and-coming earnings on the 26th. And based off of previous earnings that have already been reported, a lot of these stocks are pulling back, so just be able to anticipate or prepare for that before thinking that it has to reverse based off of where it's at right now. So as of right now, again, being at $88 and previous highs at $99, that offers a little bit over a 13% ROI. We've talked about Boeing before. Boeing has been selling off after its 180-day highs, a continuous descending pattern. It broke below the SMA line. It made lower lows, lower highs. It is doing a good job kind of consolidating around this $200 range, but we're definitely not indicating signs of an uptrend just yet. It also has earnings on the 27th of January. Please take that into consideration, because if that acts as a negative catalyst, this can only lead it to bleed even more. So if you choose to buy early, make sure it's an effective position size that you can tolerate that pullback or be able to manage that risk a little bit easier. The next one is going to be ticker symbol C. This is Citigroup. Nice little pullback after making 180-day highs, and this is because it reported earnings. This can easily continue to drop, but one of the things that I really like about this, it's continuously been showing signs of higher highs and higher lows, so it's really nice to see a healthy pullback, be able to buy it for a better deal, and then once we get proper indication of a reversal, be able to ride it back up. This doesn't offer crazy return, but 8 to 9% on a perfect trade, even if you capture 4 to 5% of that, again, a goal is something to work towards. The next one I want to talk about is CDAY. You can see that it's been very, very bullish for the past 180 days. I hit overall highs at 112 nearly, and then pulled on back. It does a very good job holding above above the SMA line, and now it's consolidating right around $100, and now we're waiting for indication of this reversal. So from where we're at as of right now to previous highs, a little bit over a 10% potential when it comes down to previous returns. As of right now, again, very common support level at 360 for Costco. That's ticker symbol COST. Previous resistance level at 380. I think this is as basic as it gets when it comes down to technicals. You guys can see the obvious resistance range right around 380 and obvious support range right around 360. So you can see why we're paying attention to it at these levels. It doesn't mean that it has to bounce here. It just means that it's bounced here before. So because of that, looking at where we're at as of right now and previous resistance levels, it offers nearly a 5% ROI. Again, it's not a crazy return, but it's been very consistent. And of course, it's Costco, which is huge, especially here in the States itself. The next one I wanna talk about is Copart. This one's been in our radar for quite some time. After it tested the support at the SMA line, it's still selling off. It broke below the SMA line. And this is why we always say patterns tend to repeat themselves. They don't always have to. It's bounced here before. Now it broke below that support level. So now we really have to wait for that indication of a reversal. So I'll set another alert here. It's great to see that it's building nice little margin if it were to make a reversal, but this thing can easily continue to make lower lows before it actually formulates a reversal. The next one is ticker symbol CRSR. Testing support levels at the SMA line, just like it has before, based off of previous resistance levels right around $45 and where we're at right now, this one offers nearly a 16% ROI based off of previous highs. And this is why I'm talking about it, because I think based off of, you know, a lot of people wanting to approach more aggressive moving stocks, this thing isn't anything crazy, but 16% in comparison to something like Costco where it's 4 to 5%, again, the higher the risk, the higher the reward. You just have to do a very good job managing that overall opportunity, right? So I wanted to talk about this one very quickly. And this is Disney. And yes, I am talking about Disney. $184 is its previous 180-day high. And you guys can see that it's pulling on back to the SMA line. Right now, it's trading right around 170. Again, this thing isn't something that offers crazy return, but a 9% margin on something that's been so bullish the past couple of months, I thought it would be something worth talking about if it were to show signs of an overall reversal. Facebook has up-and-coming earnings, so make sure you take that into consideration on the 27th of January. It is making lower lows and lower highs as of right now, so it has a lot to prove. I would like to see higher highs and higher lows above the EMA line, very similar to this, right? And as of right now, it's doing the exact opposite. I just thought it would be great to add this to your watch list, set those alerts, so once we get that confirmation of the higher highs and higher lows, then we can follow up with it and see if it's something that we want to choose to be a part of. The next one is ticker symbol FSLR. So this is First Solar. Beautiful pullback to the SMA line. And as you guys can see, it does an amazing job bouncing off the SMA line. This is as like ideal as it gets for an overall ascending uptrend pattern. Overall highs right around 110. As of right now, it's right around $96. So looking at that profit potential, right? That's a 15% potential that this stock has to offer based off of where it's at right now and previous highs. Patterns tend to repeat themselves. They don't always have to. It can still break below the SMA line, so make sure you stay patient with your entry and make sure you're careful with that position size. Of course, we're going to talk about Lulu. It broke below the SMA line last week on the 180-day chart, and if anything, it hasn't really been making higher highs anymore, so just make sure you take that into consideration. It's trying to find a support level just like it has before, right around 340, but it still has a lot to prove. So I have all my alerts set up here, but I also have all my alerts set down here just so I stay up to date with the overall direction. Microsoft, also, again, very important week that we're coming up on. The 26th of January is going to be reporting earnings, and I think we're going to be seeing a big shift and a very consistent trend, whether a lot of these are pushing up or a lot of these tech stocks begin to pull back. So as of right now, previous support level right around that 210 area, and based off previous resistance levels, it's right around 220, and the previous one right around 225. So looking at where it's at right now and previous resistance levels, it's about a 6% ROI. Ticker symbol NET, the reason I'm talking about this, it just recently pulled back to the SMA line. Really nice setup, has up and coming earnings. This one's gonna be early February, so this is February 11th. And as you guys can see right here, again, we're just waiting for proper confirmation of a reversal and working towards the goal of $88, which is the previous 180-day highs, and that's a 12% ROI. This is NIO. pulling back to the SMA line after making 180-day highs after NIO day. You guys know that I don't trade this one myself, but I have to respect the way that it trades, and that's why I'm talking about it, because I know it might meet some of your guys' criteria. And what I want to talk about is normally it pulls back to the SMA line just like we've seen here before. It will consolidate, and then it'll formulate this overall reversal. So it's not that you want to buy heavy in right now, as it still offers a lot of pullback potential based off previous patterns, but once it begins to consolidate and you want to watch it around that SMA line area, and if it begins to indicate signs of an uptrend, just like on the last push, you know, it sees pretty decent ROIs when it comes down to that. So again, this isn't something that I trade myself, but I have to respect the way that it trades, and this one offers nearly a 40% ROI after it pulls back to the SMA line. So the next one is going to be QNST. QNST pulling back from 180-day highs, testing SMA line, and as you guys can see, it's been doing a beautiful job based off of the previous 180 days, showing signs of higher highs and higher lows. And I want to keep this super short and sweet. It is so much easier, it's still not easy, but so much easier to make money in the market consistently when the overall direction is in your favor. Think about it. If you've ever struggled to trade or to invest, it's most likely because you're trying to buy the dip on something that's still selling off or that has been previously selling off. Yes, this thing is pulling back right now, but it has a history of making higher highs and higher lows. So if we just do our simple part and waiting for a good deal, waiting for proper confirmation of it breaking above the EMA line, making higher highs and higher lows, working towards 180-day highs, then again, I feel like that's a step in the right direction. The next one is ticker symbol RIDE. This one's still pulling back as of right now, but it had a really nice rally, almost hitting highs of $30. It tends to pull back to around that $20 area, and from $20 to around $30, it offers a nearly 40% ROI, so that's why I'm talking about it. The next one is Snap-on, ticker symbol SNA. You guys can see that on the 180-day analysis, it has a very consistent ascending uptrend pattern. It's testing the SMA line right here with previous resistance levels right around 180. So as we're consolidating here, let's just make sure that we set those alerts, that we get that proper confirmation. And this isn't something that offers either a crazy ROI, but it's so consistent. And if you are someone that's struggling to grow your account, then maybe focusing on stocks that are more bullish than bearish can be a step in the right direction. The next one is Snapchat. Snapchat hit 180-day highs, pulled on back to the SMA line very, very aggressively as up-and-coming earnings on the 2nd of February. And as of right now, right around $50 is where it stands. And based off of previous resistance levels, that's a little bit over 10% potential based off of previous highs. And all we have to do is wait for confirmation to see if it's time to buy or if we're going to begin to make some lower lows and lower highs. I know that this isn't a stock, it's an ETF, and this one follows the S&P 500, but I wanted to make sure that I talk about it. Since the S&P 500 and the overall market, NASDAQ, all pulled back last week, it's really nice to see that the ETFs are also pulling back as it's healthy, right? A nice little correction. They're right around the SMA line, and as you guys can see, it does a great job very, very often bouncing off the SMA line. It doesn't always have to, but when it does, and then it gets going, again, it's just a nice little trade. And it's the same thing with TQQQ, which we're going to get to right now. This is ticker symbol TAN, so really nice pullback here. This one has a little bit of a lower volume, so just make sure you take that into consideration. And also, it does a really nice job that when it pulls back close to the SMA line, it tends to bounce, and it's been more bullish than it has been bearish the past couple of months as well. So looking at the SMA line, and if it were to get to that $100 range, and based off of previous resistance levels, that's over a 25% ROI. TQQQ, which is the NASDAQ ETF, at SMA line, and looking at SMA line and where it's at right now and previous resistance levels, you guys can see that it offers a little bit over a 7% ROI. Again, nothing crazy, but it's been very consistent. And if you like buying the dips when it comes down to the overall market and seeing if you can ride it for recovery, then this is just one of many options. So the one that I'm really paying attention to is Twitter. Twitter aggressively sold off due to the news last week, and it is trading right now right around $45. It also has up-and-coming earnings reports on the 9th of February. This doesn't mean that just because I'm watching it that it has to go up. All I know is I have it in my watch list for a reason, and I have my alerts set. So if it begins to indicate signs of an uptrend based off of where we're at right now and previous resistance levels, it's over 20% potential that it has to offer based off of previous highs. But the more patient you stay, the more it could sell off and the better deal that you can get. So please take that into consideration, that just because it's oversold doesn't make it a good buy right now. Verizon Wireless, ticker symbol VZ. We talked about this one in our Sunday stock talk. The thing I found very attractive about this one is that we are approaching previous support levels at $56. It's been making lower lows and lower highs for about a month and a half. And I am excited to follow up with it because it's reaching these previous support levels at these levels and how it's traded before and previous highs. The ROI is pretty solid when it comes down to the upside versus the downside based off of Verizon's kind of like history, right? So I just wanted to take that one into consideration. Wells Fargo, this is a perfect example of why I always say it's so important to wait for earnings report. People always think that, oh, I want to buy before earnings because it's bound to shoot up. Right now, there's so much uncertainty with just the presidential election and with everything that's going on with COVID that something like this can happen where it reports earnings, it's at 180-day highs, and it pulls on back pretty aggressive. This is great for those that are not already in it, and this is why I'm talking about it, because if you wait and you wait for after earnings and there's a negative reaction, this is where you can do your part in taking advantage of a discounted stock. And that's really just it, because these tend to act as a negative catalyst from time to time and they don't last forever, right? So they recover within either a couple of days or a couple of weeks if the news is not so detrimental. So right now it's pulling on back. It could still continue to sell off. But the thing that I'm excited about this one is that it's been consistently making higher highs and higher lows. And this little pullback allows me to get Wells Fargo for a decent deal based off of previous prices. So I wanted to add Walmart just because it has been selling off and based off of 180-day highs, it's at a decent price. It just hasn't been very, very consistent. And I just think that has to do with the overall uncertainty right now going on. And the last one that we're gonna be talking about is ticker symbol WTRH. It has also a really nice pullback as of right now based off previous highs. This isn't something that, again, offers a crazy, crazy return, but a little bit over 10% based off of current price points and where it's been before. I can see a pullback to previous lows at $2.73. One of the things that I want to say is I don't trade stocks that are less than $5. This isn't something that I would trade. As you can see with that profit potential alone, it's more of a high risk, high reward type of stock. It, just because it doesn't meet my criteria doesn't mean that it can't meet yours. I just wanted to talk about certain stocks that, you know, I saw were a little bit more on the oversold side, a little bit on the cheaper side based off of previous trading prices, and allow you and encourage you to do your own due diligence and your own analysis and cherry pick, right? You're obviously not going to add all of these over 20 stocks to your watch list. And this is why I have so many different watch lists myself. There's a lot of stocks that are pulling back, and it's your job to cherry pick the ones that you potentially see value in and that you can actually see yourself buy when they get to certain prices or when they're at certain prices that meet your criteria. So I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. You guys know that I love making them for you. All I ask you is, if it's not too much to ask, if you can drop a thumbs up, it really means a lot. Also, don't forget to stay connected. We do run the largest free Facebook group in the world for those who trade in the stock market, and that's that first link down below. If you guys haven't joined our live trading session ever and you would like to join us tomorrow, click the second link down below, learn a little bit more about our Learn Plan Profit group, exactly what is included. And if you want to get a taste of what it's like to watch me trade live, scroll all the way down and watch one of these live trading videos so you can join us as soon as tomorrow at market open. So I really do appreciate you guys' time. Thank you for everyone that shared their top stock in the watch list and the group alerts. So I made sure that I did my job in analyzing them, and I began to cherry pick the ones that I personally saw value in. So really do appreciate you guys' time. If you feel like I missed a stock, all we ask you to do is to comment that stock down below, the ticker call out format, and why it is that you see value in it. Until then, we'll see you guys on the next one. Take it easy, team.